Blog Talk Radio.
Rappers that they keep rewards. Give them back McDonald's, give back Burger King, they waffles. Serving y'all niggas human flesh for a dollar. Give them back that turban, give them back that Arab culture. Give them back that false trust that y'all was paranoid. Incorporate my eye and give them back that patriarchal. Bullshit and everything your mouth can say he saw.
Peace, family, and welcome to the Subconscious Outlet. Is Goddess Michaela with us? Okay, well, my name is Coach Shauna Claley. I am your host, and we are joined today by two amazing co-hosts. We have God King Grasshop and our guest host, Mind Over Matter. Mind Over Matter, are you with us?
Peace, yes, I am.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing good, Z. How you doing?
I'm really excited about today's show. Before we get into it, I wanted to ask you and God King Grasshop a few questions.
Sure.
Are you guys ready? I was sitting here thinking about the show, and I was really contemplating on what hip-hop really was. And so I'm going to ask you... No, actually, I'm going to ask you first, what does RBG mean, and where did it originate from?
Can you ask me, Mind Over Matter?
Yeah, Mind Over Matter.
Okay. RBG is an acronym, and it has its roots with Marcus Garvey, the red, black, and green. The world-known definition of it is red for the blood of the people, black for the skin, the hue of the people, and the green for the land. With this new generation, we take it a little bit further, and, you know, it's righteous black God, Real Black Girl. You know, it's a lot. It has many acronyms, but it's centered in red, black, and green, race first, helping us. Us first. Let's try that for duration.
I love that. I know we just celebrated Marcus Garvey recently, and I know that he also was one of the founders of the RBG movement, RBG, Red, Black, and Green. But I see you repping it a lot, so I wanted to ask you so what is it to you? I love that. You said it meant righteous. Go back and say the one for that you recreated it.
Righteous Black Gods, Real Black Girls. Random black generosity.
Oh, I love that. That's powerful.
Revolutionary but gangster. You know, it's a lot. Revolutionary but gangster.
I love that. That's powerful. And while I have you with me, because God King Grasshopper will join us in a minute, because we are live at Craft Unity Center right now. We're also celebrating the 43rd solar return of Tupac Amaru Shakur. So he'll be joining us shortly. But I want to ask you, what does hip-hop mean for you?
Hip-hop, to me, it used to mean word from the streets. Back when I was young, you know, bumping that Arabian Rakim, it was always word from the street. It had a positive message. It also had the street culture to it, but it wasn't like how it is today. You could actually, you know, you can learn something from it. Today it's a little bit different, and you get people who are not even really involved in it dictating what it is, and once that money slip up in there, everything goes awry.
Right, right. And that's exactly what has happened recently with hip-hop and how it's changed so much. I was talking to a Jugna of mine, and I'm not sure, just some history on rap altogether. I was speaking to a Jugna of mine today, and Jugna is an Ethiopian term for teacher. And we don't use the word mentor because we all know what mentor means, or if we don't know, mentor was a homosexual. So we don't use the word mentor. But my Jugna was telling me that rap goes all the way back to the ancient days. He was explaining that back in the past, the griot means a historian, the griots would have battles.
Yeah.
And just like we have rap battles. And instead of having wars, the griots would have battles, basically going over their history. And that's where really the battle rapping even started. So that's really interesting to recognize that we, even though we're so far removed from our African heritage, so much of what we do today, right, it's still connected.
It's in us. I used to be amazed at it too, but now I'm not even fazed by it. It's a whole lot more we got to bring up out of us. Once you get in that right frequency, you'll be surprised at a lot of things that we still carry over from our ancestors from antiquity times.
Right, right, and we're still those same people. We may be in a different land, but we are the same exact people.
Same people who still do the same greatness.
Well, you know, I know that today we are also allowing other people to share their greatness with us, to call in and promote their businesses and their music and what they're doing. But today is a real special day. Today is actually a real special day. I'm really excited that we have Brother Jay joining us from the X-Clan. So that's going to be big, and that's going to be in the second half of the show.
Yes, that's the second hour. And we're waiting for the brother. Yeah. We're waiting for the brother AWACS to call in. Do you know if he's in the queue right now?
What's his last four?
His last four is 7026.
Hold one second. I'll let you know.
I think the sister said he is in the queue. Still there?
AWACS is in the queue, so let's introduce him to the listeners. Go ahead.
AWACS.
Peace.
Peace, brother. How you doing? Go ahead and announce yourself for the listeners.
Yeah, this your brother Africa Wax, better known as AWACS. How the family doing? Hotel.
Hotel, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good, you know, maintaining, enjoying this RBG Blog Talk Radio Show.
can just chime in.
Indeed.
Yes, sir.
For the people that don't know, the song, the opening song we open up with, that's the brother right here. I shared his video on my page, and he got good reviews. I don't know why the brother ain't bigger. I mean, it's this. That's all I want to listen to right now. RBG rap. That's it.
Yeah, that's right. Appreciate it.
Uh-huh. So, Brother AWAC, what do you do? What's your music about?
My music, you know, I kind of put it in my own lane of genre. You know, I kind of call it, I call it conscious, you know, but it's more on the brink of gangster consciousness. You know how you got conscious rap, but then, you know, you got gangster rap. You know, I kind of put it in a way where it can be infused with what resonate with the youth, you know, what resonate with the people foremost, you know, but more on a scale where, you know, the youth, our people out there in the streets can understand it better. So
powerful.
Yeah.
Powerful. So, Brother God, mind over matter, are we getting a little sample of the music today, or we just gonna give a little small bio on what our music's about?
Oh, just a bio about what the music is about, because we want to give everybody a fair chance to call in. Brother right here, he welcome to go ahead and speak on his full career until the next brother that's due to call in, I believe, Big Sid.
Okay, cool. So how long have you been working on your music?
Well, I've been in this field, like, I've been doing music for a while, but, you know, I really got off into my own lane, you know, with RBG music, like, since 2012, you know.
Okay.
So, yeah.
And what inspired you to go into the RBG music?
You know, the condition of our people, you know.
Right.
I mean, we got, you know, we get our youth, they listen to music, you know, and a lot of the elders can't talk to the youth. So I use my music on that type of aspect right there, you know. Because, you know, if you actually listen to my lyrics, you know, I use the lyrics on my behalf. You know what I mean?
Oh, wow.
I'm a real lyricist, but, you know, I keep it real with the people, though, you know. I don't just use it to try to be better than the next artist, you know, or just try to be a great MC. I use it, you know, in the form of a message, you know, my beats. I use the beats that people resonate with, the beats that make people dance, the beats that make you bob your head, so.
And who are some of the people that and they're in the music game that inspired you to do this? Like, who? Name some of your favorite musicians.
Well, I don't really have a favorite, you know, that's in the industry as of right now. But, you know, of course, my the greatest of all time, Tupac Shakur. You know, that represents the revolution. That represents RBG.
Right.
So, yeah. Of course, you know, Dead Prez.
Right.
Those brothers, yeah, Dead Prez, the Outlaws, you know, they grind. It's, you know, they grind inspires me, because even though they kind of blackballed by the system, they still travel the different countries and, you know, and continue to grind like that and make money, you know. So,
right.
Yeah.
And since we have you on the air and you have a little bit of time with us, how about you just drop of one verse, just a little something, and give us a sample of what you're working with?
I thought they already dropped the verse for me. Y'all gonna throw me on the spot like that? Okay.
Just a little something. No, you don't gotta go too deep. Just give us a two-liner. Give us something.
Okay, let me see. I actually got a book of rhymes, but sitting right beside me. But I don't really want to do nothing fresh since y'all put me on the spot. I do this verse I did on this piece called Christ Versa a while back. But the lyrics go, dog matter, bronze plasma, pastor after the rapture, God, Adam, Eve, deceit after the apple, genes of Isis back in the chapter, casket for Caspian daddy, born of a virgin, I'm black as a bastard, It's a white world, feel like I'm trapped in Alaska. About to burn this motherfucker down to the gravel. After the math will be P.E. unravel the mat, resurrect Kendrick Johnson and pass him a get the massacre. Serial murder should be in church with a serial number tag to his hearse. Meet me in person, we can free the world from harm or hurt. Just take the white man off of Mother Earth, this mother's curse. And force a verdict that no devil can endure. No one can divert the pain affliction aimed against the main offenders. Hanging niggas, Bibles don't pertain to niggas. Ain't the nigga that you want to lead. Draw your pistol while I paint this picture. If it was vice versa, I ain't a killer. Damming rivers of blood through the judge and grudge. Leaving dead pecker woods in the woods. If heaven was hell, heaven would be in a cell saying prayers. Knowing it ain't a motherfucker there to care. Though I'm praying regardless through all the pain and the hardship, hoping for heaven cause I'm a walking target. Embarked on this path off and heartless, following Garvey. And when I put my shirt up and flash it, I'm Mardi Gras shit, off shit, crackers talk shit, about this raw shit. Trying to write my future with no past, you ain't bought shit. Socrates type doctrines, you ain't got shit. Philosophy monopolied out of a false myth. I'm morphing in the Morpheus, fuck a habeas corpus, leaving behind corpses and orphans. Stuck in the roughness of voicing the mortals like markers, like Torrentel Pro Bum in the Panthers office, the headquarters. I leave a cracker here to quarter, inch off his shoulders. Let the whole world know that we soldiers. Yeah, it's Pan Africa, we bout to turn the stove up. You don't believe in hell, well, we bout to burn you hoes up. Well, yeah, a little something like that.
That was hot. So, if you want to ask him some questions?
How you feel about the frequency of the music right now?
Oh, the frequency of the mainstream music? The small hat mainstream music. Okay. It's definitely anti-African, you know, definitely. It's definitely detrimental to on every level, you know. When we look at the artists that we used to resonate with, like Erykah Badu, you know, artists like that, Nas, you know, they in the system now, you know, it's
right,
they on the other side now. So we gotta really be very, 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 very careful with who we consider a god, you know, in the industry that to influence us, our people and our children, because I believe, without a shadow of a doubt, that the industry is designed for our destruction.
You get that light too?
Okay.
You know what you just touched on was deep because I've been thinking about that, like, what happened with Erykah Badu? Like, how did she come out? Go ahead.
Erykah's one of my favorites. Yeah, exactly. She got the whole movement of Baduism. You know, she used to be the favorite of a lot of us. You know, a lot of us would never expect Erykah to be a coon, the coon that she is today. You know, I did not expect
for her to turn out the way. And I'm trying to figure out, guys, cause, you know, we all know that Lauryn Hill had to just completely leave it after a while. Like, she was literally going crazy.
Exactly.
And so, we don't know what's happening behind the scenes, but when I've seen Erykah Badu lose it, after being such a, and you know, India Ari bleached her skin.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
After being singing brown skin, I'm wondering, like, are they being programmed?
Yeah.
You know, like,
I mean,
what
I call it the Queen Latifah effect, right?
Right.
Because you know, you got Janelle Monáe.
Mm-hmm.
Janelle Monáe is the new Queen Latifah because she took the same path that Queen Latifah took, because of the simple fact that the song that put her on was a song called Queen, right? That put Janelle Monáe on was the song called Queen. And Erykah Badu was featured on that song. Last year at the BET Awards, she performed last with Erykah Badu. She performed that song. She took the same steps that Queen Latifah made. She is now the spokesperson for CoverGirl.
Hey, you want to do like
that? Y'all know about that?
I heard about that.
Spokeswoman for CoverGirl or something like that, Janelle Monáe. And I seen a picture, most recent picture I seen of her and Erykah Badu was Erykah was in the front and Janelle Monáe was across from Beyonce, and it looked like they was finna kiss each other in the mouth. You know what I mean? And, you know, so I believe that she took the same steps that Queen Latifah took, because everybody know Queen Latifah a lesbian. So, I mean, they pushing this whole lesbianism agenda, and I believe that, you know, any woman who deals with Beyonce is a part of that, is a part of that major problem right there.
Big Ted in the house.
Yeah, definitely.
Seems like Panther Party might come through, but...
All right, brother, we want to thank you for calling in, Brother A-Wax.
Yeah, plenty of much, brother.
Thank you for calling in. Let them know where they can find you on YouTube.
Oh, you can find me on YouTube, A-Wax, capital A, lowercase y, lowercase e, capital W, capital A, capital X. You can find me on YouTube. You can also find me on Facebook under the same name, and also... you can send me a friend request on Facebook. Just type in Afu, A-F-U, Ra, R-A, Ka, K-A, last name Wax.
Indeed, brother. Peace. Thank you.
All right, Hotep family.
Hotep.
Thank you.
We got the brother Grasshopper. Is he on now, too?
Yeah, he's on. Brother Grasshopper, are you on?
Yeah, can y'all hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, brother.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah, my apologies, man. I'm up here at the Tupac event trying to get things straight, squared away up here, though.
Man, I'm going to see you down there.
What are you talking about? No, it's got to do with RBG and hip-hop. Fill me in. Or you just want me to go into what I feel about hip-hop?
I'm
going to see you down there in a minute.
Oh, you coming down? That'll be bomb.
We got another caller right now. We got a caller with the last four of 3018.
Yeah, let them in.
You have a question, sir, or you want to?
Peace.
Yes,
this is All Black For Real. How you doing, Mind Over Matter?
Oh, what's going on, man? We trying to on this segment right here. We trying to take all the calls from somebody who got a CD to put out or an artist or something like that. So if you can call back in the next hour when Brother Jay is on.
Right.
All right, brother. Thank you.
I'll do that later.
Peace.
Yeah, Brother God Grasshopper, are you still with us?
Yeah, I'm here.
We did touch on the meaning of hip hop and what it represented to ourselves. And Mind Over Matter, he has some amazing acronyms for RBG that I had never heard before. But let me ask you, what does hip hop mean to you?
Well, hip hop to me is not just relegated or narrowed to music. You know, as KRS-One is fond of saying, it's a distinction between rapping and hip-hop. You know, rapping is an occupation that one does. Hip-hop is a lifestyle that one lives. So pretty much hip-hop is a way of life. Even when you base it on the many essentials of hip-hop, you know, DJing, graffiti, breaking, MCing, and a thorough knowledge of self encompass all of that. That's pretty much deals with even the spiritual essence or elements of life, you know, with the air, water, fire, life, or earth that encompasses life. So to me, hip-hop, once again, is a way of life. It is poetry. It is oratory. It is music. It is athletics. It is just everything you can encompass when it comes to life. So that's what hip-hop is to me. It goes beyond music. It is a way of life, so pretty much. And since we got on, we have Brother Jay on later on, you know, it's also culture as well, African culture.
Definitely. We waiting on that. Uh-oh. So we got another caller in the queue with the last four of 0794. Are you there?
Hi. Yes, I'm here.
Peace. How you doing? Who's this?
I'm good. My name is La Ariel.
Peace, La Ariel.
Hi. I was calling in because Kateria told me about your show, and she said that I should call in and let you guys know about my mixtape.
Oh, definitely. Let
us know about it. Yeah, I just released it like a week and a half ago. It's a mixtape that I recorded on my computer. I used a lot of tracks from Drake and some other popular hip-hop artists, and I just wanted to spread the word because I'm a singer and a songwriter, so I use those tracks as a medium to write new music on top of it and kind of spread the word about myself as a singer and a songwriter. So, yeah, I'm just trying to get the word out there and let people know about it. It's a free download.
What's good to be?
And
I need a green light.
Oh, sorry.
Go ahead. Yeah, it's a free download, and it's on my Bandcamp site. So if people are interested, they could check it out. I was hoping, I don't know, do you guys play music at all, or is it strictly talk radio? Or?
Oh, we do both, but you want to give us a little sample of what you got, you can go and open
yeah.
a couple lines. We're not going to be going too much into the music.
Okay. I don't know how it would translate if I play it through my phone, but I can try. Do you think I should do that?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, I'll play a little bit, and y'all let me know how it sounds. You guys hear that all right? Hello?
I can hear the beat.
Sounds good.
Oh, cool. Thank you. Yeah, that was just the beginning of a song called Sober that I wrote about a love relationship, and I kind of used sober as like a metaphor for being very deep in love. And yeah, that's it. That's one of the songs that's on the mixtape.
I got a question for the sister.
Yeah, what's up?
What type of subject matter do you speak about?
Mostly about love and relationships.
Love and relationships?
Yeah,
okay.
Mainly about things like that, whether it's something I've experienced or people close to me have experienced, and I kind of put it to song.
Do you have any YouTube videos, or where can the people find you at?
Yeah, I have a YouTube channel. My name, again, is La Ariel, so it's spelled L-A-A-E-R-I-A-L. Just think Ariel, like an aerial view, but with a law in front. And you can find me online everywhere under the username 4LaLaLove. So on Instagram and Twitter, it's the number 4LaLaLove. I think 4LaLaLove.
Wow, thank you so much, sis. Are you performing at the family reunion?
No, I'm actually based in New York. So,
okay.
I just wanted to call in and I've been listening to the show and everything, and I just wanted to call in and share that with you guys.
Oh, well, thank you so much. Thank you for calling in.
No problem. Bless. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you, sister.
Have a good one.
Hey, let me chime in real quick. It's Grasshopper family. I'm going to have to leave because I got to take care of business up here. But I know the show's going to be black and it's going to be well. And if anybody's in the greater Los Angeles area, come on out. We're honoring Tupac's 43rd solo return celebration. In my opinion, the king of hip-hop. So anyway, I got to sign off. Got to take care of business up here. But black love, black power, hit tap.
Black power,
What's
brother,
up?
Peace.
Peace. All right, so mind over matter. You can see the calls that are coming in. I can't see them.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay,
next up,
cool.
We got, I believe it's Big Sid, RBG, with the last four of 0060.
Yo.
Peace.
Black Power.
Black Power, Big Sid.
What's the deal, brother? You all right?
Man, we good. We good. How you doing?
All right, chilling, man. Out here in this hot Dallas, Texas heat, trying to stay cool.
Man, I can imagine. I can imagine, brother. Yeah, man. We want to let the people know who you are. So go ahead and speak on yourself and your career.
Oh man, Big Sid, Mr. Tookie Hoover, RBG Soldier, Revolutionary Brand Gangster. You know, my music is straight for the. Street RBG cats, you know what I'm saying, have nots, you know, I'm kind of in my own lane, you know what I'm saying, and if you want to go to, you know what I'm saying, and see any of my videos and performances, you can go to www.bigsaidmusic.com, but, yeah, I mean, you know, I'm in my own lane, man, I don't bow down, I ain't trying to get no deal, you know what I'm saying, I'm straight independent, gonna stay independent. You know what I'm saying? Actually, when you understand the grind, you know what I'm saying, you can actually make a lot of money off being independent than actually, you know what I'm saying, signing to the labels. But, you know, the subject matter that I speak on, they ain't going, you know what I'm saying, they ain't going to bow down to it. You know what I'm saying? My shit's straight revolutionary, you know what I'm saying, unapologetic, You know what I'm saying? So that ain't really what they want. That ain't what, that's not the agenda that they pushing right now. You know what I'm saying?
The mainstream, they don't want to hear that, but we want to hear that, though. That's what the people want. We want to hear that.
Right. And that's what, you know what I'm saying? And like I tell cats all the time, like I don't write my rhymes for RBG cats or conscious cats. I write it for the street cats to get them on game. You know what I'm saying? Because we all know our brothers is sick. So when a person is sick and we know music is medicine, we got to put some cut on it. Can't just give it to them. You know what I'm saying? 100%. Just, you know what I'm saying? Black power, Africa, da da da. We still got to put some cut on it that they can understand it. And then when they come in, you know what I'm saying, we can give them a stronger dose, you know what I'm saying, which is introducing them to not just music, but teachers, you know what I'm saying, our master teachers, because my music has brought plenty of people into the knowledge, you know what I'm saying. They done hit me up and was like, bro, I got your CD, man, and you were saying some shit that my homie was saying when I was locked up, but I ain't never heard nobody say it the way you saying it. So then that's when I can hit them on to Dr. Ben or Seti or, you know what I'm saying, Brother Polite or, you know what I'm saying, wherever it's like we got to find our niche on what tribe everybody from, because, you know what I'm saying, we all come from different tribes, you know what I'm saying. That's what all of the different organizations is, in my opinion, with the RBGs, Nation of Islam, the Wabians, Hebrew Israelite, Moors, you know what I'm saying. We all different tribes, but it's kind of like we still Garveyites because we all got one aim, one God, one destiny. You know what I'm saying? And I bring that in my music. You know what I'm saying? Because some people be coming at me like my album cover, Black Power Cartel Part 2. I put the American flag and the red, black, and green flag. They're like, man, what'd you put the American flag up there for? Because I'm still trying to reach our people. Who, you know, that's that cut that I got to put on it. It's got to be a controversial, but we still got to track the people that's not on the knowledge. You know what I'm saying? I think sometimes we try to still concentrate on people that's on the knowledge to still, you know what I'm saying, going back and forth over the same, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of like the debate shit that's going on now.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's kind of, remember what Malcolm said? He said, if we bring religion and keep talking about our belief systems and our religion, we ain't going to get nowhere. We're going to continue to argue. You know what I'm saying? We're going to have to come to common grounds on what needs to be done right now for our future and our babies. You know, so that's, and the debate series has, it's kind of like I don't want to see like-minded brothers debate. I want to see Polite debate a Scientology cat, or, you know what I'm saying, Seti debate one of these Egyptology cats, you know what I'm saying, or one of the brothers debate a Christian preacher, you know, but that's debating each other, man. That's kind of like, okay, it was cool, but now let's move on to something else, because you already know we've been bred to hate each other anyway, so us being competitive towards each other, we got to be very careful. Because it's really easy for us to fall into that nigga competitive where I don't fool with you because you that, and I don't fool with you because you that, when it's like, nah, brother, y'all brothers, you know what I'm saying? And my music tries to blend in that gap, build that bridge and build the bridge with the brothers in the ghettos and the streets, you know what I'm saying?
Wow, that's good that you recognize that medium, brother.
I enjoy it. I was going to say, I agree with everything that you're saying. One thing that you touched on is learning how to speak a universal language that everyone can understand and using music to be the medicine of that, and that's powerful.
Right.
I wanted to ask you, you said something about being independent, you can make more money than going mainstream. Can you give the listeners and the other people who are in the music industry some tips on how to do that?
Okay. I love that question. Okay, this how I do it, and this is the blueprint I give everybody. You know, I don't have no one that can run my internet for me all day while I stay in the studio and make music, as well as pass out my CDs and my flyers, and you know. So what I suggest our independent artists to do is to get in the studio, build up your music catalog, get you some singles. Don't, like, I think sometimes we focus on trying to get a whole album done when sometimes you can get a nice single and push that single and make some money off that single. But build your catalog up. Then once your catalog up, you have to come out of the studio and become the your own promoter. You have to get your flyers, get your CDs. And like I tell people all the time, sometimes you really have to give away your CD. You know what I'm saying? Because CDs, yeah. I mean, you get 100 pack of CDs for $30, $20 sometimes. So that's really nothing. You know what I'm saying? Because the CD is really replacing the flyer. You know, so that's when, you know what I'm saying? And they are they taking your music home with them where they can listen to it and constantly. And then after that, you still have to set up your own shows. Even if 10 people come out. It don't matter if that ten more people that can, you know, and if they see you grinding and constantly doing shows but selling your music online, you know, it really needs to be a seminar, you know, because it's like not enough time that I could really just go just deep and depth to it but that really needs to be a strong seminar on how independent music can be sold because it's very easy. I mean, it's very easy. Like, just like how I got behind Syrah Student Seti with the lecture series. So, you know, Seti pack out the house. So all I got to do is go where he at, boom, hit the stage, whoop, sell at least, I'm going to sell at least 20 CDs, 10 T-shirts, you know, and like I always tell people, be sure you you give the people a show. Rehearse your show. Sometimes I do an a cappella show. A cappella. Like straight, like no beats, no nothing. While I'm, because it's kind of like a lecture, but it's in rhymes and I'm talking to the people. It depends on, because you know, you got to feel the crowd out. But you have to rehearse, constantly get in that mirror, look at yourself, and know your stuff backwards and forward, and be sure you putting on a show. A very entertaining show, because that's what's going to make people buy your music, not just you getting up there reciting a poem, especially in the conscious community, because, you know, with us, you got to do a backflip, a front flip. You got to flow. You got to levitate while reciting the law for them to even believe in you or even want to even support you. You know how we are.
You know what? What you said was really profound. I was listening today to, I don't know if you guys are familiar with, I think it's Russell Simmons. He has a book and a audio CD called Super Rich. But one of the things that he talks about is doing things for free. And he talks about if you want to be in the music industry, the fastest way to get noticed is to give out your music for free.
I'm going to tell you one thing that I did. You remember the Black College Tour, right?
Mm-hmm.
The BET Black College Tour?
Yeah, I remember that.
This is how I got my biggest following. I went online, saw what college that they was going to be at. I started in Atlanta. My brother stayed in Atlanta, so I knew I ain't had to pay for a hotel, no nothing. I drove there. I passed out 1,000 CDs. They was going to be in Birmingham at Alabama A&M, wherever Alabama A&M is. They was going to be there the next week. I drove there, passed out another 1,000 CDs, showed the DJ what I was doing. He gave me 5 minutes. Whoop.
Rocked. Wow.
Then came, if this is me and my brother in the car, we ain't got no Monster energy drink behind us, nobody behind us, just doing it. And this is how, like, I sold so many CDs. Some people were just giving me money just where I was telling them where I was from. And then what made it even so bad, because I followed them all the way back to Texas, to Pine Bluff, to the Black College that's in Arkansas. I went to Jackson State. I didn't catch when they was in Louisiana. It just passed out all my CDs for nothing. And some people give me $20, $10, $5.
Wow. What's your name again?
Big Sid.
You know what? You have such a powerful energy that I just want to remember your name, because I know you're going to become somebody so powerful. Because you're
you
really, really practicing the laws of success.
Yes, thanks, sis. And like, I have so much to say in such a small time because I know y'all got other callers.
Especially when you want, huh? We want you to spit something before you go.
Already.
Okay.
Huh?
Give us a little taste of what you got.
All right, here we go. Long Star RBGs. Hey, it's Mr. Tookie Hoover, boy, you know me. Man, I bet it all on that red, black, and the green. Man, we nation builders ain't serving no things. I'm a Kushite blowing Kush crown, me the king. Kush Copperfield disappeared from the scene. Reappeared with the cracker under the bin. Remember Rosewood? Yeah, big baby, don't squeeze. Big said to my brother's keeper. For the slaves, I'm a cracker killer. On a suicide mission with the reaper. I was born to die for black people. Return to Detroit, red, screaming, fuck the feds. My seed is my sequel. I'm a Garveyitis going down tonight. But this time I'm strapped with ill heat. Yep.
Definitely, brother. Hey, I like that video too, brother.
Which one?
The Hoover.
Oh, okay.
That was really powerful. I enjoyed that.
Appreciate that, sis. And, you know, I got a BPC V3 coming. That's Black Power Cartel Volume 3 coming. You know, I'm still pumping the gas. You know what I'm saying? I got the Gas album coming. I got a Smoke album coming, too, called Virgin Mary, the Seedless Edition. But the main two things that I'm really pushing is my two singles. Is the You Thought You Knew Me and the Rock. And Mondo, man, I need to get with you too off of line, man, because I need some promo team that way, man.
Okay, man, just inbox Hollywood. I'm here.
Okay, because I need to send you some CDs, man, so you know what I'm saying. So, you know. But we need to talk offline, man, so we can get some things popping, because I need a strong link that way.
And let me state it emphatically so everybody can hear too. I'm here with no drama, zero drama.
Okay.
Zero drama. Yeah, that means like the normal little things we go through with dealing with some of our people, that's eliminated with me because I already understand the hustle.
Already. That's one of the most important things to know.
That's how things get moving. That's how things get moving.
For real. Man, hey, man, I appreciate y'all, man.
We appreciate you for calling in with all that valuable information.
Yeah.
All right,
yeah,
bro.
Thank you.
Well, hey, www.bigsaidmusic.com. Y'all go have some fun. Sit down. Get some popcorn. It get revolutionized real quick on my music. I got interviews. I got the fundraiser that me and Cyrus Sunsetti did for African Care Academy and Uhuru Academy. We raised like $7,000. So, you know, I got all that footage on the videos there, so y'all can go there and have some fun, man.
Definitely.
Say your web address one more time, clearly.
www.bigsaidmusic.com.
Thanks again, Brother God. Thank you.
All right, bro. All right, sis. Appreciate it.
Peace.
Black power.
Peace.
Black power.
So, mind over matter.
Yes, sister.
I just have a question. Do you, in the future, you know, I know where the hip-hop game is right now, and I know where it came from. Do you think that it can be turned around? Do you think that, money has completely bought it out, or do you think that there's an opportunity for it to go back to its original roots?
I think it definitely can turn around. You just got to have the right players on the field for that. I mean, people hungry right now. People hungry for something that's different. I mean, you know, it's the same run-of-the-mill lyrics. It's the same type of the antics, you know, the things that they're doing in these videos. I completely don't even watch it. I'm sticking to all the ones who was a little bit before this generation right here. Not all of them, but, you know, these newer ones. To me, it is social intelligence. I can't really ride in the car and listen to this dude talk about shrimp and caviar and foreign cars. I'm not living that life, nor do I aspire to live that life, you know. And if that's his aspirations in life, that's cool, but that's all they talk about.
Right, just materialistic.
And some of them dudes, they go a whole full CD, which is like some of them over an hour, are talking about nothing. Death and destruction,
right.
Genocide, that's it.
Right. And I mean, can you name even a handful of people that are in the game right now that you do think are representing consciousness? Or do you think, you know, how many people can you name right now that are representing consciousness?
It's probably more that I'm not aware of, because I don't venture off too much, but I listen to, like, you know, the basics, the Dead Prez, the Immortal
right.
Techniques, Tech Nine, what's the brother's name? Talib Kweli,
right.
Mos Def. You know, there's a lot of West Coast artists that's still with the gangsters that I listen to, because they're not on that nonsense. Dub C.
Right.
You know, so it's a lot that I'm not aware of, but it definitely can be turned around once, you know what, the people got to get behind it. The people right now, they're not asking for anything other than these club songs and the pill popping and all that. That's what the people, this generation, is asking for. So that's what's being put out there.
Now, how did we lose it, though? Like, you know, if hip-hop was what it was in the past, and, you know, the artists were able to rap about the truth and all that stuff, how did it end up getting manipulated? Like, you know, were we, you know, I'm not really an extreme hip-hop head. I listen to Saw Rock, I listen to Dead Prez, I listen to certain people, but I don't really know the complete history on how it transitioned into what it turned, you know, to this pop rap now.
You know what? I'm not even going to sit up here and try to front like I'm Mr. Hip-Hop. I mean, I grew up with – I could produce pictures of me holding a big-ass boombox on my shoulders, bumping Eric B. and Rakim. I used to live in Jersey. So, yeah, I'm mm-hmm. definitely from the culture. I grew up on hip-hop. To me, a big part of it where it went wrong was the way a lot of states took gangster rap. You know, gangster rap was something that knew. It changed the game.
Right.
You know, because as much as the East Coast can boast that, you know, we put rap on the map, and, you know, and the East Coast has always been known for the conscious lyrics and you know, the build sessions and everything like that, it seemed like when N.W.A. came out with those, like, you know, hood songs in real life, how we live out here on the West Coast, it kind of made some other states kind of, like, try to do, the mimic thing. And that's where a lot of things got twisted. You had people who were players trying to be gangsters, and you had people who were just straight squares trying to be gangsters.
Right. Oh, that's deep that you said that. Now, what's crazy for me is that now that we have gone so far into this, like, pop rap, you can go back and listen to, you know, even the gangster rap of the past, N.W.A. things like that, and that even sounds more conscious now.
Now, ain't that something? Ain't that something? Matter of fact, you can take probably one of the most ignorant songs N.W.A. made, and it stands mounds above this new rap today.
Oh, right, it does. It really does.
Yeah, that's a trip you say that, because I was in the car the other day listening to K-Day, and they put on Dope Man. Remember Dope Man?
I don't know how
By N.W.A. They put on Dope Man, and that song.
I think
song,
I like that album.
Yeah, it's a hell of a message up in there. It always been, but just to hear it again today compared to what's out there now, that was some hell of a lyrics by Ice Cube.
Right, I listened to it. Now I was even telling Grasshopper, like Tupac was literally considered, you know, a conscious rapper, even though they were, you know, against him when he was out, like, oh, his music is, you know, degrading the people and all that. You listen to it now, and he was telling the story. He was telling what was really going on, and what you hear nowadays is just horrible. It has no content whatsoever. You know, and it's really just to dumb you down. It's all like dumb you down music.
Let me ask you something, coming from a sister's perspective. How do you feel? You probably don't go out, and I don't go out to these places, but we know it does happen. But how do you feel knowing as a black female, that somewhere in some club, when a song is thrown on that says, you know, bitch, I'm gonna fuck you, you know, all this crazy shit, and the first one to hop up and throw their hands in the air is a sister. That's my shit. How that make
right.
you feel?
You know, that it really makes me depressed, you know, because one, it's almost like we become robots. We literally have become programmed. So, you know, just getting on the metaphysics, because, you know, that's what I like. That's my expertise. Dealing with the subconscious mind, hearing something so many times, and I'm going to give you a story. I remember when that song by, what's his name? I can't deal with that. I'm in love with a stripper. What's that guy? T-Pain. Okay, when I'm in love with a stripper first came out, I could not stand that song. I went around on just like this whole militia, like, we, that's the worst song in the world. I didn't think he was attractive. The song was unattractive, everything. But the way the mind works, and this is what we all need to pay attention to, anything you hear repetitively enough times, the subconscious accepts it and it thinks that it likes it. So that's how we get programmed. So I heard I'm in love with a stripper over a million times. And by the end of, like, the 100 million times, 101 million times, I liked the song. And what was crazy was that I remember not liking the song. So I was sitting there contemplating one day on how is it that that song became catchy. You know, all of a sudden I'm rocking to the beat. You know what I'm saying? But that's what they do, is that they play that raunchy song or whatever song it is over and 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 over. And even when you know you don't like it, before you know it, you catch yourself singing those lyrics. That's why we have to guard our minds, because it's not a coincidence that all of a sudden this pop rap is taking over. It's not a coincidence that sister in the club is throwing up her hands saying, "Ooh, that's my song." And we hear these songs, we have no content whatsoever to them but curse words and, you know, degrading the sisters and calling, like you said, calling them out their names, talking about how they going to hit it and quit it and all this stuff going on.
Yeah.
And they thinking that's their song, but that's how that program works. And, you know, that just, that on the reverse of that, when we think about how powerful music is and why the government is trying to manipulate the music, because they know how powerful that music is. Just like you said, that sister in the club throwing her hands up, she's programmed. So the same way if she has some song being played over and over about being a queen, that same thing would start to take effect in her mind, and she would be programmed to be like, "Oh, that's who I am," you know. But they're making it a point to manipulate that music because they realize the power. And I think for us, and when hip hop came out, you know, they thought that was going to be a fad. They thought hip hop was going to come and go. But when they saw how it was influencing the people and the power that hip hop had, just like when we, like right now, like I said, when we're over here celebrating Tupac, they recognized that his lyrics had a lot of power over the people. You know what I'm saying? So when they realized the power of the music, and music being one of the number one ways to get into the subconscious mind, if they can control the music, they can control the people. It's not a coincidence that, you know, now they have music out that has homosexual content in it, and you have more and more effeminized males running around here. You know, this is all programming.
Yeah.
You know, this is all straight programming. Not to cut you off,
the sister just gave me a notice. We got another artist in the queue right now. Artist Lavelle Streets with the last four of 2405.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hello.
Peace. Lavelle Streets.
Yes, sir.
What's going on?
Man, I'm just out here enjoying the day, man. I'm actually at a, it's like another family reunion over here from one of my boys just got back from tour, and I'm just over here vibing out with them, you know, just enjoying the day.
That's right.
Yes, sir. So yes, sir, man.
You got any projects out?
Yeah, I actually have one. My latest project, which is Word on the Streets, I recently dropped that, and I'm working on new music right now with a family member of mine called, named Jay Bars, called The Bartenders. But right now, you know, I'm really just pushing my latest project, Word on the Streets. And yeah, that's my latest music.
Okay, Ned, let the people know where to find you at on YouTube, or if you got a web page or anything.
Yeah, you can find that on Lavelle Streets, LAVELLSTREETS .bandcamp, BANDCAMP.com, and or you can also visit my multimedia site, which is procityvault.com, procityvault, I'm saying a lot of letters, .com, but yeah.
Okay, brother. You got anything you want to spit for us right now? You got time?
Yeah, I mean, definitely. I could spit some. And I heard y'all's over here. Y'all's going in with the whole the power of music and influence, man. That was pretty dope.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, because that does hold some weight, because people do. You were saying that, like, you didn't like a song, the T-Pain song, and next thing you know, it's like you rocking to it in the car or something. Like, I know I didn't like this because I do the same thing. And now that I'm like, I know, and then I listen, I'll be like, all right, if I don't like this song, I know. And then once they play it so much on the radio, I listen like, I know I don't like this song, but now I'm like, what's going on? Yeah. So, yeah.
Right.
So I definitely felt you on that. Yeah, and the power, like when you said Pac, he had like, he wasn't like the greatest spitter, but his music and his voice was so powerful, it just, you know, people felt, well, it was almost like a conversation, like he's telling you something. So it went to a whole nother realm than just music.
Right.
Now it's like he's giving you something that you can actually learn from, which is not, I mean, you can turn on the radio and you're not, it's three things you're going to learn. Can I cuss on the radio? Hello?
Go ahead, brother.
Oh, no, it's like three things you're going to learn, you know, getting money, F&Bs, and drinking, partying, baby. There's really no substance in it. So I definitely felt that part of the conversation I heard that you guys were discussing.
Appreciate it.
Okay.
But, I got you. Let's see what I got here. All right. Hey, what I got? Hey, that's on the spot. All right. Let's see what I got. Dang, what can I spit? And we live, man. Shout out to the listeners for paying attention and listening. All right. A lot of dope that I quote. Ain't no reason for me to be dealing it. When I spit, I'm flipping bricks. I turn on TV and start feeling sick. My mind stuck on guerrilla militant. Nothing as real as this. Since a little kid, I should have been arrested for my ass. The day I wrote my first verse, I was killing shit with the simplest formula. Notice my flow just grotesque. Oh, yes. As time goes by like a chick attracted to both sex, at your cortex, meaning pad, dwelling by the past, I'll be on the path, headed to the lab, while this rap game getting pretty sad, niggas is trash, but luckily I'm the one who got him ready to run like Diggy's dad, is he mad, is he nice, I'm taking bad and good advice, cause that's a part of living life, right? Look, life is what you make it. How to figure out the matrix. It's the reason that I'm hotter than the weather out in Vegas. Multiplied by the sun with a gun that's dirty with over 100 bodies inside of a G-Rod from a nigga that's on the run. One.
That's
yeah,
nice.
Yeah.
That was hot.
Good look.
That was
good
hot.
Looking, good looking. Yeah, man.
Can you tell the listeners how to reach you? How can we contact you? If somebody heard you right now and said, I need to talk to him, how could they find
man,
you?
You can find me on all social networks. Just type in Lavelle Streets, LaveLStreets. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. You know, just if you don't know social networks, just go to search and type that in, and that's where you can find me.
Okay, Ashe. Brother, we want to thank you again for calling in.
Man, thank y'all for letting me showcase my abilities, and, you know, y'all keep dropping them jewels.
Give thanks. Indeed, give thanks for you sharing your talents with us.
No problem.
Peace.
Peace.
We got another caller.
I'll let him in.
Caller with the last four of 6551.
Six 551, are you with us? We probably lost them. If you get an opportunity, call back so we can let you in.
Yeah, definitely.
Now, you know, I wanted to point out something to you. If we don't have another caller, I wanted to point out something to you that has been just profound. You know, since we're doing the Tupac event today, you know, we've been watching a lot of Tupac documentaries, Thug Angel, just different ones that he has out. And one thing that he says in almost every documentary, I even saw an interview than he did while he was in jail. And I want all of our people to really pay attention to this because, you know, like I said, one of the things that I have to stress is metaphysics and the subconscious mind and how that works. One thing Tupac says in almost every documentary is that he was not living a thug life until he started rapping about it. In one of his documentaries, he literally said that the day his album came out, he had never been in jail before. He was rapping about other people's stories, what they had experienced. You know how we use, like you said, everybody wanted to do that gangster rap.
Yes.
You know, so he was rapping what other people were experiencing. And the day his album came out, he had been arrested for the first time. Never had a record.
Wow.
And he got arrested the first time for jaywalking and ended up going through getting beat up by the police and everything. And that's how the mind works. But he said literally he didn't start having the problems he had until he started rapping about it. And then it got worse when he started playing those characters in movies. You know, he played in Juice and he played certain characters. That was not Tupac. That wasn't his true personality. That's what became his personality.
He spoke it into existence.
Say it again.
He spoke it into existence.
He spoke it into existence along with his death, along with him and Biggie. Both spoke a lot about their dying and, you know, how long were they mourn me. And we at that time, we were like, wow, they must be prophets. You know, they just knew. But no, they were speaking it into his death. And even Malcolm X and Martin Luther King, right before they died, they both spoke about they were about to die. So we have to pay attention to that. Like, it's right in our face. If you ever go back and go look at some of his documentaries, he always says it. He wasn't living that life until he started rapping about it.
How's the event looking down there right now for y'all? Because I definitely want to come down there.
It is pretty packed. There's a lot of people showing up. We got Tasha Set performing. Impact is performing.
Is that a free event?
Yeah, it's a free event. They take in love donations, but it's free. It's free. If you want to donate, they're more than willing to accept it. But it's a free event, and there's a lot of people already here. If you guys hear the noise in the background, it's because a lot of people are here. And so I'm trying to find. Okay, let them in.
Caller with the last four, 6551.
Hotep, what's going on, people?
Hotep, peace.
Hotep, peace.
What's going on, my sister? I listened to your show a few times. It's my first time calling in. This Morton Brown.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. You know, Sister Z told me if I got time, call in and spit something for y'all, so I do that. I want to talk about some of the topics y'all talking about right now. Now with the rap, like the brother was saying, everything did change with the birth of N.W.A. They brought in N.W.A.
You there, brother?
I think we lost him.
You gotta get a better connection. Yeah, we hear you.
Y'all
hear
me?
Yes.
Yeah. With the birth of N.W.A., that neutralized Public Enemy and groups like that. You know, all the positive rap, the uplifting rap. You know what I'm saying? With the birth of N.W.A., that started the decline. That started the thug life and the gangster rap. You know what I'm saying? Things changed after that. That was the big swing, major swing.
Okay. Do you think any type of gangster rap was positive, or was it just all bad once gangster rap came out?
Nah, it wasn't all bad. I mean, them brothers was telling the truth. I mean, they was giving you a glimpse of the hood. Before that, you never really got a true glimpse of the hood. I mean, me being from the South, the ghetto boys did their thing for us down here. They gave us a glimpse of the hood. You know, for y'all, the West Coast, N.W.A. gave a good glimpse of what was really going on in y'all area. Then other
right.
people followed suit. You know, it was some cats that was really living it. But, I mean, like, nowadays, most of the cats that's talking what they're talking, they're not living it. It's just
right.
talk. And, you know, so, like, I mean, rap is so watered down today. And, like, the difference with Pac and Biggie, like you were saying, they spoken into existence. Now, them them brothers knew. In Pac's case, Pac broke the oath. You know, like I don't know how much y'all really know about the underground scene and the Illuminati and the Baphomet and stuff like that, but Pac broke the oath a few times with things that he said. So it wasn't but a matter of time with him.
No,
you know, he was speaking too much. Like if you go back, if you look at that interview with him and Snoop, when he was talking about the media, stuff like that, you can see the look on Snoop's face, like he said something he shouldn't have said. I mean, it's certain interviews that where things get pointed out. I mean, it's a lot of different things. There's a couple of videos I could point you to where a couple of people slow it down and show you certain things.
Wow.
Looks on the face and certain stuff that he said. Like Professor Griff break a lot of stuff down and a couple of other people.
It's not only that, too. It's also in lyrics, too. You know, a lot of rappers, they do that today. That G-code is not enforced no more. In fact, it's almost like no G-code now. People say things now for a reaction. And at the time, a lot of people do believe Pac did get caught up in that super hardcore thug life and kind of, you know, left the G-code alone, because a lot of songs, when you get in that studio and you start rapping, you naming names and places, you're not supposed to do that.
Yeah, I mean, like, really? When he was talking about the Illuminati, you know, he killed the Illuminati, he putting the K to that because he killing that, and if he alive, we'll have our own parties and this and that. That interview right there was the beginning of his downfall. I don't know if y'all remember that interview.
Y'all seen
that? That was the beginning of Pac's downfall right there. You know, he said a whole lot of things a little bit before, but a lot more afterwards, and so he knew it was but a matter of time. For Biggie, they say Biggie was a sacrifice. I'm not really sure about that, but I mean, it's a whole lot go with it. You know, the rap game is very crazy.
What type of rap you listen to? Some of the artists.
I listen to a little bit of everything. Like I'm more Texas based. Like a lot of our artists down here are independent, so some of them y'all heard of, some of them y'all might not have. Like far as the conscious rap, we have a Houston artist, K Reno. You know, like Sister V, she plays some of his songs on Me and Lamar's show. Like a great song that you can YouTube is Death of the Machines, and what's my favorite? It's The Great Grand Deception. Okay, YouTube The Grand Deception and watch that video. And as the lyrics go on, whoever did his video give you a glimpse of everything that he's talking about. And you know,
wow.
Now, K. Reno, he's been doing this thing for quite some time. He's pretty deep. You know, a lot of his stuff is on YouTube, a lot of his stuff. But I listen to the Immortal Techniques and Talib Kweli and stuff like that. I mean, I dabbled somewhat in the rap game here and there. I mean, I did street rap. And during my Christian time, I did a lot of Christian rap, but me being conscious now, I do a lot of conscious rap now.
And that's leading me to my next question.
I ain't gonna hold y'all up. I'll spit something for y'all.
Go ahead.
Since it wasn't requested. All right. Y'all can hear me pretty good?
Yeah.
Indeed.
All right. My thoughts are in the galaxies where everything aligns with no technicalities. I'm sun-powered, human solar panel, I need no batteries. Time traveling, mental challenging, mind portal at the base of my spine, just follow the line. I'm extraterrestrial, more than celestial, melanin material equipped for this battlefield. You hear the skills, atomically feel, here's the deal. Let's open the seals, because they reveal things that don't appear to those who are not real and ready to ascend. It starts within. When you were born, the transformation begin. Here I stand, the ultimate human, trained and banned, the black man from the black land, comedically blessed with technology that makes skeptics have a brain seize. Today's MCs lack the intricacies to be on this level. I blend with the bass and the treble. The militant rebel strikes the sound waves. Wake up or remain the mind slave.
Ooh,
like
that
was hot. Yeah, like that.
Oh, yeah, I love that. That was powerful. And how can they find you? And tell them a little bit about your show.
Best way to reach me is probably on Facebook. Just Martin MB Brown. Type that in and hit me up and we'll go from there. Or you can hit me up through We the People, the group We the People, Facebook group We the People.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, that's pretty much the easiest way to get in touch with me.
All right. When is your show on, Martin?
Say that one more time.
When's your radio show on?
On Wednesdays. Me and Brother Lamar, we break down the Bible. That's what we're doing right now. We're breaking down the Bible metaphysically and literally and astronomically. It's really showing what it really means. I mean, because a lot of times most people read it and don't really know how to read it. You know, like some of that stuff they take literal. And really it's just a metaphor for you.
Right. That's powerful.
All right, brother, we want to thank you again for calling in.
Yes.
Yeah, hotel, my people.
Peace. We're gonna cut to the break right now, and then we'll try to get in contact with the brother Jay. Brother said he's gonna be on a move traveling, but he said he's gonna try to make it happen. So let's try to inbox him and get him on here. So we're gonna take a break right now and we'll be right back.
All right.
It's the Messenger Group X Clan. Here's the 9. The movement Black Watch. And when we're not outraged about the oppression upon the black existence, we step to you in blackness. By the way, exist in a state of vainglorious as we are protected by the red, the black, and the green. Heed the words of the brother.
Let us the word the phrase, the paragraph. Heed masters, day begins class. The science of past is now brought to the rhyme fix. From the scrolls, state to the verse. God's the God, from God's the man. Many kings, many leaders, a fist from a hand. They call me militant, now what does this mean? Do I carry a gun to make the army scene? With the cause I never pause, as simply as a brother. Raise the flag, wave the colors. Red, black, green with the key, the difference. Words make a way in the world and the instant. Living to die and I die to live again. 6 degrees, comprehend. A man getting stronger till he's man no longer. Unearthly state makes the time move shorter. The ever radiant awareness, born forth the one. Open eyes, strong sun. Patterns and priests standing by what I teach. So you all stand starving as I start to leave. Words are gone. Brought from the Genesis. Will exist, so Armageddon is a witness. The originals built the earth. One must be aggression to learn a basic lesson. Quite majestic, stern within reality. A juggernaut when you tamper with mentality. I wear a crown, extension and dimension of a brain cell. Bringing hell to the shell out. The ever tangled web we weave. Always trying to obtain, no attempt to achieve. Descendants of kings and queens act like justice. Never potential, quarter of the measure. Jealousy of what are we? Become tendency for their thievery. Alright, cool. But no need to pull the trigger, that's a fool. I get my words like that in my school. To produce the words that they fool about. It's another way of taking out these sissies. Who may try to extinct my principality. But of course not having me madness. From beginning, I'm the end. Observe me. Ignorance is not a trend. So as I beckon, for a few seconds, pull the reins. Is a foresight first. Egyptian, African, now I'm on a black watch. Check my sundial, slipping like the clock. I can catch a shadow as the moon reflects the sun. Creator's eyes make a path of brother one. So now I walk softly and carry a big stick, a bird stick, so you natives will lick. Then brings the funk and spreads jam to the wheat bread. And the folk of this one vainglorious, unearthly resistance, strong with persistence, grand verbal allocation, tribal connection, pyramids, witness the funk bearer, vibe sharer, not the era. Brother is bound like the scales of thought, and neither my demand makes stone move soft. Corrupt all systems, positive poison of me. Some call it onk, it's a key. Black is a color while blackness, state of a mind state. But how many of you say today, Brother Jay can find a better way? So be it. Plan it down and make it say I serve a purpose. Yet I'm not the G.I. Joe, I am the brother. Yo, I could never swear a bunch of this step to the mic and stage areas. I drop the science that breaks the clock barrier. Words of old make me more than a beginner. The key opens knowledge and plays in an antenna. Americana man, Africana brother. Don't forget the land, cause the birth is from the mother. A vibe is in place, obtained and discovered. Tune in your audio and hear the words of brother.
Yo, Aristotle, Plato, Socrates.
your team. Step on.
Peace, peace, family, and welcome back to the Subconscious Outlet. We are just waiting on Brother Jay to join us. He'll be joining us shortly. Until then, we are still taking in more callers. Brother God, Mind Over Matter, are you with me?
Yes, I am.
All right, so let's bring in some more callers.
I believe we got Brother Dawood online.
Yes, indeed.
Brother Dawood.
He's a caller with the last four digits. Don't forget me. You know what I'm saying? Hip hop,
yeah.
RBG ain't nothing without Z. How y'all doing?
Right. Let's welcome our goddess sister, Miss Z. Welcome.
Welcome, sis. Thank you. Thank you. Hotel people, everybody that's listening in, one love. Let's go on and get to this first caller. Caller with the last four digits, 2417. You're on the air with the Super Conscious Outlet. How y'all doing?
Peace and Black Power family, what's happening? This is Brother Dawood. What's going
peace,
on?
Peace, Brother, peace.
Mind over matter, what's happening, bro? We back at it again, man. What's going on with you?
Oh, man, we enjoying this this day. We just waiting on the brother right now. You know, he said he's going to be out and about, but he's going to try to make it happen. But hopefully he can get in here before the show closes out.
Right.
But the show still go on. Glad you called in.
For sure, man. I always stick to my commitment. But I'm going to drop it like this. Me, personally, right, I was born in 87, at the height of the crack era, right? And at the time when, if anybody knows about music, that's when music had some sort of morals. In my opinion, that was the last era of meanings and morals within the music, right? Because at the end of the day, it would have some sort of impact and make you actually want to get up and do shit or change shit. Now, today, with this rap music, what I call Rage Against the People, because that's what rap stands for, in my opinion, Raging Against the People, because that's exactly what it does to the people's minds. It excludes the people's minds' frequencies and has them raging against each other. That's why I said Rage Against the People. With that being said, how are we, comrades, warriors, those who have knowledge of self, and who have the eyes and the ears to see through the bullshit that's being portrayed in the media, how do we communicate with the youth of today who are growing up with this stuff that's going on today, thinking that it's normal, this is natural, this is the right way to go? Because like the sister said earlier, they get you with a beat. All they need is a hot beat with a dope frequency
right.
in it. It tunes into
right.
your, you know what I'm saying, tunes into your subconscious, and with that hot beat, you can say all kinds of bullshit on top of it that makes no sense, but as long as that beat is banging, because we are asking
mm-hmm.
people to stop with the beat, how do we get into a baby's mind and tell them, yo, listen, turn that shit off, really and truly, and get back
right.
into something really going to, you know what I'm saying, instill in your mind to make you really want to do something positive out here for your people. How do we do that?
Right. You know, that's a good question, because I'm going to tell you the truth. I found my daughter sneaking to listen to the radio one day. She had a headphone in the radio in the bathroom, because I'm against the radio altogether. I don't listen to it in my car. I don't
right.
listen to it in my house. So she had my little old boombox and had it in it. You know, she's 12. She's going through that teenager stage. And I guess, you know, I don't know what they talk about at school, but she had it, her headphones on. So, you know, we have, like you said, we have to educate our children. And we have to bring them to, like, what we're doing right now. We have a bunch of sisters and brothers and a lot of young children here. And, you know, we're doing conscious music and we're celebrating Tupac Shakur's life. But we bring our children around a community that is going to educate them, that is going to make Black power and make consciousness a normal part of their life where this is not odd. I have to teach my kids. Like I said, I still caught her sneaking to hear that garbage. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like a drug now. You know, it's literally become a drug.
It really is. And the sad part, now that you brought up the systems part, which is very vital, because not for nothing, like you said earlier with the whole T-Pain thing or whatever, you didn't like
right.
it, but after a while, through repetition, you know what I'm saying, it got you. It even got you. But now to the point, it's now to the point, man, you just turn on the radio, it doesn't matter what station. Even here in New York, WBLS, right? At one point in time, BLS was like the adult station. You had your soul, your R&B, you know, your old folks or whatever. Now,
right.
that same station, that very same station, they basically, you know, pop that, bust that, all that same shit.
Wow.
And it makes no sense. And just like you said, our sisters love it. The first day, like
right.
in the street, in the street, they hear the word bitch, they want to get offended, they want to slap you, want to get all riled up, whatever,
right.
whatever. But if a rapper says, yo, bitch, pop that pussy, ow, that's my shit right there. You can't
right. Right.
And they take, but little do they know, with that same energy that they're giving to that song, they're going to take that same energy back home to their children and don't even realize that
right.
they're doing it.
Right. Oh, I mean, I've been seeing it now where it's not so bad in the community where you got kids twerking, little girls twerking on videos.
Grown folk doing this shit now, too. That's the part that I'm trying to get to. It's not even it's affecting our whole community, from the elders
right.
to the babies. That's not even here yet.
Right.
Like,
and that just goes away. Go ahead, brother.
I agree with that press said in that song. Turn off the radio. Turn off that bullshit. Real talk, straight
right.
up and down.
Right.
Me personally, I don't listen to rap music. If you want to be honest with me, I listen to straight up roots and culture reggae music because not for nothing, that right there. If you listen to any roots and culture artist, whether it be Luton Fire, Stephen Marley, any of these cats out there, whatever, they have something that is a vital message that our people here in America can listen to and be like, you know what, even though that's going on in Jamaica or whatever island that's from, it's the same shit. Same people, same enemy, but yet all you have to do is just simply switch your frequency ear to it, and you'll be able to tap into it. But because, again, they got all these hot beats, you know what I'm saying,
right.
hot drum that touch our African soul, because, again, African people, we communicate through drums. So all you need is that dope beat, and you can say whatever the hell you want. You can say the damn ABCs over a dope-ass beat,
mm-hmm.
and that record will go platinum.
Right.
Let me ask you this right here.
I honestly think that some of these radio stations need to get shut the hell down. Real talk.
Oh, definitely. Let me ask you this, though, Dawu.
What's up?
Well,
how do you feel about when you articulate these things to someone about this music and they say,
yep.
well, okay, but I just like the beat?
Right.
That's breaking it down to
and
them.
That's mainly what it is.
Because, yeah. If they say they like the beat, but at the end of the day, they can recite the lyrics backwards, forwards.
Well, exactly.
But nobody's problem.
Now,
and if you
now
really
think about it. How did you learn your ABCs? How did we learn our ABCs? We learned our ABCs singing it. A,
yep.
B, C. So even when you come up to somebody asks you, okay, what comes after T, you'll find yourself going A, B, C, D, E, F, and you grown.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you
yep.
still singing it. So that's what a beat and some words do. It will go right into your subconscious mind, and before you know it, you playing the song in your head. I could pull up a song and play the full song in my head right now and not have the music here with me. You know what I'm saying? So the program goes in, and people, like you said, all they got to do, like you said, got to get a catchy beat, and that's why I know the government is using it, because it's literally changing our whole community. Like you said earlier, the elders are twerking. The children are twerking. Everyone in between are twerking. Now we got boys twerking. Okay?
Yep.
It's getting out of control. But we have to realize the power that music has and take back that power.
Definitely. And, Brother Dawu, we want to thank you for calling in. We got a whole lot of callers. We're going to accept the next one.
Peace and black power, y'all. Y'all do it up.
Peace and black
peace
power.
Peace and black power to you, Brother God. Peace.
Next
All
caller,
right,
you on the line?
We have the next caller, and the next caller is last four digits 5883. You're on the air with the Super Conscious Outlet.
Greetings.
Who are you speaking to? Greetings. How you doing?
Hi, this is Mother Latrell out of Albany. And as I was saying, I'm personally not an artist. My daughter is an artist. She does poetry and she sings, but not write her own songs yet. And when she's doing her song, I'll be trying to explain to her about.
Did the sister get cut off or hello?
Sorry, she was on the cell. Hello, we here.
I'm still here.
Okay. Go ahead.
Yeah, we lost you for a minute.
Well, I was saying my daughter's an artist, I'm not, but I call myself a connoisseur of sound because I don't always remember the words to the song, but I had to break the habit of saying, oh, I like the beats, because I was one of those people that would say I like the beats because I never caught the words, but then when I started to pay mind to the words themselves, I cut off rap as a whole because it's garbage. It's like poison, like drops of arsenic bit by bit going into our into our system through sounds and tones. And so I just agree with what you said. I'm glad I was able to catch the show today.
Oh, I'm so happy you tuned in, sis.
I am.
You're too. Right. I was. Go ahead, sis.
I was just saying that was into my thoughts.
Oh, I was looking at something today, and it said that our DNA can literally be restructured through music. So, like, it's literally affecting our DNA.
Yes.
The music we're listening to. So that's amazing when we think about it.
I know that could be true. I agree with that, too. I've heard that, and I've, you know, built with other persons in regards to that. Just how powerful, how deep the effect of music is, especially music that has low vibration compared to the high vibration.
Right.
And then
you add
the words on top of it, it's like chaos.
Right. Right. That's heavy. And you can tell a lot about a person by the music they listen to.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. A lot of the younger people, all ages actually listen to a lot of the rap music, the harsh sounds and the disrespect of others, of all ages. And it's like they turn around as a speaker that's going to have, build up against genetics. And they act on that, and they don't even get it. That's like, please, they go, flex the girl. You see this song? You think you feel that goes on? You hear the words? That's how you behave it. No. They don't even get to have the show with two steps up on the way. It's like, the most people to face the song. But some, they're like, nah, and they just stay in denial. So that's their loss.
Right. Okay, well, thanks for calling in and sharing your point of view.
You're welcome.
Yes, thank you so much, sis. Okay. Well, peace and blessings to you.
Gratitude.
Peace. All right. The next caller with the last four digits, 3018. You're on the air with the Super Conscious Outlet. Who are we speaking with?
Like you talking to children.
Hello?
Tell them I'm on the air.
Can you hear us? We can hear you.
Yeah, I had my phone on the side only because it kept on beeping. I have my house phone. I need to see you.
Can we all hear
I'm
each other?
I'm asking right now. I'm on it right now. I'm going to ask it right now.
What am I going to always keep trying to tell
you? Okay, hold on. Hold on.
Who are we speaking with? Probably with the last one, digit 3018.
Peace. Yeah, it's Black Career. I was really trying to get in and talk to my brother Jay.
Oh, okay. That I know of, he's supposed to be calling in right now. We're waiting on him patiently. So if you want to be put back in the queue, I can put you back in the queue, and then when he gets in, then we'll just pull you in.
I'll talk to mine over Nada for a second, if that's okay.
Peace, brother.
I wanted to ask you, are you experienced that sometimes you will put up certain posts with pictures, and like a couple of months might pass, and all of that's gone, but when you look in your photos, the photo is still there, but all that you had written to that particular post is gone. I was wondering if you've had that occur to you as well.
I haven't been on there to check, but I know sometimes it does some funny things up on there.
Right. I was just wondering what's going on with stuff just disappearing. Is Facebook really taking over like that? That they really are censoring what you put up, and if they get around to you and decide what you have up, it's not great.
Yeah.
They want that they actually go and take it down.
Yeah, sometimes you do get flagged. You know, I've been flagged a lot of times for, they've been telling me copyright infringement because I put music up and it's not copyrighted or I didn't get permission. So I can go for that because that's against the law. But a lot of times people been reporting me. You know, I had this one picture I used to put up every now and then of Jesus on a cross getting done in, and black people would report me to the Facebook authorities and they take me off. So.
Wow.
You know, it's one of those type of things, man. It's sometimes it's technical problems, but a lot of times it's just another coon over there reporting you to Facebook, not something that they don't agree with. And a lot of times it's always Christians. I noticed that. It's always a black Christian reporting somebody on Facebook.
Well, you know, the Christians have a whole different perspective about what's going on in America, and for them to report UN, that's actually nothing to them. They actually feel like they're doing the right thing. So they're in the same category as far as I'm concerned. Like these coons that just posted some of the most garbage about us on this Facebook, that I'm wondering where their heads are at, where they're actually coming from, that they would continue to promote that type of nonsense. When, to me, Facebook is the outlet right now. Might as well use that medium to network with each other on some positivity as opposed to pushing forth that negative or reporting stuff that they feel is negative, like Jesus getting done in. So I agree with you on that note, that coons are definitely and Christians are definitely do us in. I just want to say one more thing, too, because I know you have the callers in the queue, is that with Brother Jay, I just wanted to talk with him and see if he can remember that I remember him and the Brother Israel, that I remember carrying masters up and down to the studio in Manhattan. I remember the office over in State Street in Brooklyn.
Okay, actually, hey, brother, not to cut you off, but we got word that Brother Jay then finally got on, so we want to get the brothers up in there.
Okay, so.
Thank you for calling. Thank you for calling.
All right, brother, peace.
Peace.
All right, family, so Brother Jay is about to join us. If you guys have anything to call in and share with him, give us a second, let the brother get on, and then you guys can call in and speak to him directly. Is Brother Jay with us?
Brother Jay.
Peace. Can you hear me?
Peace.
Yes, we can hear you. Peace, brother. Welcome to the Super Conscious Outlet. Thank
peace
you
and
for
blessings,
peace and blessings. Thank you for sharing your time and your intellect with us tonight.
Oh, thank you for having me. I was in the midst of travel, so that's why I was late. I apologize.
Right. Oh, no, thank no you, way. Brother Jay.
Definitely, brother. Glad to have you on the show. Glad to have you on the show, brother. But before we speak another word, we want to give thanks and blessings and a rest in Yahuru to Professor X, the Overseer, Sugar Sav, and Sonny Carson.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And Sugar Sav as well.
Sugar Sav as well.
Alambe Brad, as a gang of elders that y'all didn't get a chance to meet that were, you know, working in the coal part of the train. You know what I'm saying, giving that fuel to us. You know, there was a lot of those elders. I respect all of them, December 12th movement, all of the elders of the Restoration Plaza, you know, all of those elders who stood up for us and taught us how to have more heart, you know, all due respect.
Definitely,
yes.
Definitely. Well, you got callers waiting on you, so let's let the next caller in.
No doubt.
All right. So the caller with the last four digits, 4-2. You're on the air, Brother Jay,
in
the Super Conscious Outlet.
Peace.
Peace, brother.
Can you
speak
it
through?
Peace,
Brother
Jay. Respect. Nine of the matter, Koshana, Demiah. Y'all hear me? Because right now I'm out here. It's my anniversary, and I was just wondering if you guys can hear me. If the background is too loud, I want to try to walk
hear you.
With a little bit quieter.
We hear you, brother.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. Brother Jay, peace, man. Big ups. I was born in 1964, so when Brother Jay and them was out with the X-Clan, those were some of my first experiences with hip-hop. And I just want to tell you, brothers, you know, Sugar Shav, Brother Jay, Overseer, you know, you guys were really a big influence on my life at that time. You know, I heard your sister Koshana speak on how Tupac was saying he was rapping somebody else's story. Well, N.W.A. and those guys, they were rapping our story. Being, you know, a young man coming up, we lived that. The things they were rapping about as far as the West Coast and the gang lifestyle, that was us. That was us. I mean, that's what we were doing. I mean, you know, getting high, drinking the Cisco, putting in work on the enemy set. That's what we did. That was our way of life. So it was realistic for us. You know what I mean? But Brother Jay, what I really wanted to ask you, I'm really elated. I used to be a part of this show, but now, you know, I'm a family man. I had to kind of put my priorities in place. There's no love lost for anybody in the superconscious or subconscious outlet, whatever it's called right now. There's no love lost. You know?
Right.
But what I wanted to ask you, Brother Jay, is in your experience, you know what I mean, being in the hip-hop scene and being a part of the RBG movement, what really came from that? I mean, like I said, because you guys came out, and that kind of actually persuaded me to like leave the gang life alone a little bit, little by little. I graduated from it, you know what I mean? And I realized that it was important, it was essential for me to try to, you know, help my people to recognize who they truly were. So I just wanted to know, you know, in speaking to you, what were some of your experiences after the whole thing, you know, the kind of X-Clan movement kind of stopped? Where did it go from there? And that's a big one. That's what I'm really, like I said.
This is a long question, brother. I'm trying to figure out where you're trying to focus at. Are you asking me about the movement? Are you asking me about the music? What are you asking?
I'm asking you personal. I mean, coming up, I think, you know what I mean, the lyrics, about, you know, the movement, the knowledge, who we were. I feel like you guys were really influential on, you know, the whole thing. What, in your personal experience, what happened, you know what I mean, after that? Like, what were some of your experiences in being a part of that movement? Did you really see things change? Did you see things get worse? That's basically what more.
Well, I mean, these things are kind of obvious for the network that we even sitting on, you know, Mind Over Matter, you know. People wouldn't have had the heart to do these kind of things, you know, without those kind of movements, you know, stepping forward in entertainment. You know, X-Clan was really, you know, knocking down doors in commercial areas that, you know, that cats weren't allowed to, you know, and that was a creator's blessing. It just was us to open up a doorway. It wasn't us to set us up on a platform, because really, at the end of the day, the movement was first. You know, I mean, video shoots we've had to leave because something was happening at Brooklyn Bridge or, you know, or Yusef Hawkins situation or Eleanor Bumpus situation was going on in our hood, you know, where we had to go and defend, and we couldn't say, hey, we had to video shoot. We can't go.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So
right.
a lot of the times we felt it was a clash because our responsibility is for the movement first. You know, we were doing shows with San Fran, and, you know, Rodney King's brother would come over. We'd take the school out on King Street. You know, which is unheard of for people that want to make money and want to come back to a place. We don't care if you invite us back for a show. Something has to happen now to demonstrate, you know, cultured power right now. You know what I'm saying? Black power as a leadership tool and not as a domination. So I hope that's answering your question on where you were focusing at.
Yeah, no, definitely you answered my question, brother. I'm going to get off the line right now. I'm celebrating my 11th anniversary with my wife. Now, listen, like I said, big up to you. Much respect. Peace to Mind Over Matter, Koshana, Zimriah. You know, I wish all the best, the most success.
Peace,
you know,
brother.
Thank
enjoy
you.
Your
Thank
power.
You.
Power.
Peace,
yeah, brother. And I'll continue listening, and I'm out, man. Y'all go ahead. Bless up.
All right. The last four digits, the next caller, is 1450. You're on the air with Brother Jay in the Superconscious Outlet. Who we have on the line?
Yo, what up? It's Jay Allen. What's up?
Hey, Jay Allen. How you doing?
Hey,
Jay, how are you?
Hey, I'm good. Brother Jay, I just got two questions for you. One, I wanted to know, what was the most difficult part of you guys just surviving in the game back then when there was so much negativity as far as hip-hop starting to be on the rise? And also, I wanted to ask you, who, as far as the artists, other artists out there at that time, showed you guys the most love and embraced you?
Well, let me answer the latter ones first. Nobody really showed us love at that time because they were trying to figure us out. You know what I'm saying? We weren't PE. We weren't KRS-One. You know, you would see us on a newspaper, you know, a daily news or a post or something demonstrating for some justice, but people were really talking about it at those times. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we didn't really get the tour love because they were afraid of what we were. So we experienced a lot of prejudice in a lot of different areas because hip-hop was starting to get into a commercial angle, and we weren't commercial material, you know what I'm saying? But we had mass crowds, so it was a confusing thing our label was bold enough to take us on because they were the ones to sign Bob Marley back in the days. So they understood mm-hmm. that you can't, you know, you can't contain the power, but you can distribute and do business. So it was fortunate that our people were buying cassettes and vinyl and stuff at that time. It proved the loyalty at that time, Frank. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, right. If that's the answer where you're coming from, my lord.
Yeah, that's it. That's it. That's it. Definitely. I just want to tell you, you're a big influence for a lot of the brothers and sisters out there, and you know, we really love your music.
Thank you, fam. Thank you, fam. I appreciate it. Wise words.
Peace.
Thanks for calling in, Jay.
Right. Peace.
How's that? All right. Next caller with the last four digits, 9556. You're on the air with Brother Jay in the Super Conscious Outlet. Who are we speaking with?
Hi. Hello?
Hello.
Hey, hi. How's it going? Hotel?
Hotel.
My name is Alistair. I go by a rap name of Nuclear Nuke. Brother Jay, man, big up to you and man. It was your type of music that, you know, that really got me. When I was blessed to hear y'all type of music, man, it was, you know, it was like a breath of fresh air. It was like, you know, it was like, man, this is the truth, you know. It was like, cause I was like, when I was 17, we was in the rap group, Party On Posse. We had the, you know, the Move On whole titles, the Living In Custody, all the downgrading stuff. But, you know, fortunately, I guess, you know, it wasn't meant for us to even break through, so it didn't. And I got opportunity to hear more positive people like, you know, Paul Righteous Teacher, and, the Klan, P.E., Boogie Down, and, you know, the West Coast was pushing knowledge and unity and relying and, you know, and togetherness when, you know, when the West Coast was, you know, like they were saying, started this gangster rap stuff. But I just want to say, without guys like y'all, man, you know, my generation probably would still be lost. You know, it would have been a lot more, you know, critical. I just, you know, would just wish y'all, you know, I'm saying, I'm glad that y'all came out, man. And I'm really, you know, I'm excited to be talking to y'all while I'm a little.
I hear you, go, brother.
Yeah, yeah.
Thanks for calling in, brother.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hotep. He said he was a little bit excited. I'm telling you, when I say Brother Jay called in, I was like, Brother Jay, what you say? I was hyped up. Let me ask you this, because I'm super hyped up, and you know what I'm saying? You had us, and I'm going to say us because it's the 70s, baby. You had us so hyped up. We had African medallions, you know what I'm saying? We had dashikis on. You had us waking, you know what I'm saying? We woke up, but then I guess we fell asleep because, you know, then that's when, you know what I'm saying, the booty music and, you know what I'm saying, all the gangster music came in the mix of that. But you had, to like me, walking down the halls of my high school talking about Vainglorious. What does Vainglorious mean? Because I know you made it up.
Well, it was a word that actually Professor made up, Brother Lumumba. It was his call to freedom. It was like a salute where you can put your hand to your heart and say a word that was anti Noah Webster. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't something
right.
that people can connect to. You know, we make
right.
our own lingo. You know what I'm saying? And that's
well,
what
right.
you know. His father, Sonny Carson, always says, we write the no. You know what I'm saying? So his son created his own word to represent what Marcus Garvey meant to him, what, you know, what the liberation made to him. So it was a word for liberation soldiers to use. I mean, we still use it to this day. You know, when
right.
you do that, you know, and it's not said in a forceful way. It's always said in a laid-back or pimping type of way. You know,
right.
our definition of pimping is different. It's involved with motivation. We're not trying to take advantage of our people on no level. But there's
right.
a pocket. There's a pocket that African people have that's not described by swag and all these other things that it is.
Right.
We called it pimping at the time. You know what I'm saying? So you hear
right.
that in our lyrics. You hear that in our movement. You know, when we move around, we rode around in the caddy. You know what I'm saying? You know, in a colorful one, just to say, you know, we're not on your plane to be judged. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
These were things that my brother, you know, brought to the movement, because he was a founder of that movement. This was a hip hop culture and revolution movement combined. It had never been done. You know, we've been performing at, you know, all the RBGs know you've been performing at the elders' events, at the gymnasium and the school and all this other thing. You know, we went and we did all those dues as well. But, you know, we went and moved forward to the record labels. Architect was the manager of Latin Quarter, so he knew people in the industry. Lumumba, he was in the industry as a manager. So, you know, I wasn't that. I was from Brooklyn, you know, learning my rhyme styles. A young DJ and my boy Shaft was nice. And we came with some, you know, some conscious poetics, you know, simple as that. And that pocket, and that pocket that I'm speaking about is what got us where we're going. I know the brothers asking me on the line, like, you know, what kind of problems did you have? You know, it looked so effortless the way they all was doing it. It wasn't all good. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
This game is a greedy game, sir. You know what I'm saying? And to all the family up here at the station, this is a greedy ass game. And I tell people coming into it, your mind got to be right, because if you do start making money, you know, your altitude changes. And if you're not grooming yourself to daily create your own reparations, you know, so stop waiting for people to give it to you. Find out these areas where you have potential and privilege to serve and create your own reparations and build your own labels and outlets without question. And stop asking these people for contracts and how can I get signed and go and do whatever. Come on, man.
It's
ridiculous.
Okay.
Brother Jay, I wanted to ask a question.
Go ahead.
Real quick. You know, because you were in the music industry before and you know, you had a profound impact on a lot of people. When you look at people like Erykah Badu and the impact she also had when she was bringing African culture, what do you think would make a person just drop out of that all of a sudden just turn into something totally different overnight? Like, how does that happen?
Well, as far as how a person elevates and the
right, they start off really promoting African culture and, you know, like Erykah, she brought the unks and she brought all these things like you guys did.
Well, you got to think this, sis. It wasn't Badu by herself. Kedar was behind her movement.
Right.
And, you know, you got to remember this now. It's your backing. It's not always your talent. You're not going to rap your way to the top. Ain't nobody, you know. All of us conscious artists, we say the most profound and universal things in the world. That's not going to change the world. Your platform or where you shout that from, you know, will amplify your success. So, you know, Badu at that time with Kedar, his power at that time was monstrous. I remember getting that CD in the FedEx, all black, talking about, you know, Badu. I didn't know what it was. It sounded like Billie Holiday on hip hop beats. You know what I'm saying? I remember meeting Shorty with Q-Tip. You know what I'm saying? We was up at the studio where he used to work out at Midtown, you know, because we high school mates. So, you know, he had, you know, Shorty was in the lab. He said, this is, you know, Badu. I didn't know she was an artist or whatever. I didn't know what was going on. You know, little skinny girl, you know, in the lab. And the next thing I know, somebody was sending me a CD, and I see her with the head wrap and the incense in her mouth on BT. And the sister needed that. You know what I'm saying? The sisters needed someone. Tifa wasn't doing it, and Light wasn't conscious like that. She just was a respected sister who broke through, but she wasn't necessarily conscious. She really went on some roughneck business anyway. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, you know, we got to be, you know. But back to Badu, it was refreshing to see a sister do that. But I know the pressure of being in that position, because you want to do everything at one time while you got that spotlight. You want to, like, sage at the video shoot, and you want to, you know, say, you know, something to the orations. I remember then up until now where she doesn't care anymore. You know what I'm saying? She's been through it. The game seasons you. You know what I'm saying? It cools you down properly if you have enough time for your lava to cool and really mold to something that the people can use. They still appreciate her to this day. No matter if she's butt-naked on the video,
right.
Set a foundation for sisters singing jazz and soul, not neo soul, real soul.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Where Jill Scott was from, real soul, before they put it up on something else. So it was refreshing to see Badu, and it's hard to do that nowadays, just because jazz is not a popular medium. You know
not
what I'm
at
saying?
All.
Not at all. To this day, you know, nobody comes and say, "Hey, man, did you hear that new jazz song?" Do, 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 do.
Right.
You don't do that. So it's a difficult place to jump into. Now, when we talk about Badu, we were fresh off Diggable Planets and Tribe Called Quest album was basically 80% jazz.
True.
You know what I'm saying? So you look at how now when you talk about the sound and the tempo of music, somebody would have to come with Drake's beats doing what Badu does. You feel me?
That's true.
they would have to do that because the tempo has changed. We're not at a feel-good music pocket anymore. We're on a bounce pocket, a war pocket. That's so wild when they hear this. Boom, 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 boom. That's war drums. I don't care what kind of 808 you put on it. When you go to the black clubs and they put that music on, and them people wilding like they climbing the side of the ceiling. See, cats don't see that. All they see is the video. But when you go to the club in the hood, you really see the reaction and the wild out that happens with these drums. Conscious artists got to master that. They got to master that. That's how someone could blow up overnight. You know what I'm saying? In my opinion.
Right.
You know, if a new Badu vibration is going to come, it got to be somebody that can bust like Lauryn Hill and sing some kind of different kind of melody on some of these beats, these bounce tracks, because you're not going to get in there with jazz. You're going to get a bunch of snapping finger cats in a small cafe going around the country on Chitlin Circus. You're not going to be in bigger arenas. That's not arena music. That's not arena music. Jazz music is not arena music. If you listen to Badu stuff right now, it's not jazz based. He's rocking over Dr. Dre now at the concert.
That's
real deal.
We have another caller for you, Brother Jay. Last four digits 3018. You're on the air with Brother Jay. Hello. Who are we speaking with? I guess.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm on the air. You want
to hear? Yes, all right, Brother Jay.
Peace.
Peace. Did you have a question for him?
I didn't hear the brother.
Yeah, he didn't even say nothing yet. Probably have to go to the next caller then.
Okay. Well, then moving on to the next caller. Let's see. Caller with the last four digits, 1613. You're on the air with Brother Jay.
Peace to God. How are you?
Peace to God, my Lord. How are you?
Well, you may remember me. Your presence is greatly missed in the Atlanta area. This is the Brother Charles.
Peace, my Lord. How you been, man?
I'm well. I'm extremely well. And I'm blessed and feeling grateful. You know, that
Raul,
I hear your voice this evening.
Hey, Raul, man. Good to hear your voice, man.
Raul. It's been some time. It's definitely been some time. But I took this opportunity to reach out, and you know, I had one intention, and then I heard you speaking upon a way that we could actually carry on that movement by finding the right sort of artist who can be advised properly by brothers like yourself, and actually possibly beginning a whole new thing, you know, under the, you know, with the right person, the right people, and in place, and again, the wisdom that you just displayed, I got a whole nother plan I want to talk to you about.
All right, so let's dig into that. The problem with movements on any level is consistency.
Mm-hmm.
All right, anybody in any movement, I don't care where you come from. Consistency is the issue. With music, you have to be consistent. If you look at your top stars right now, for the past 10, 15 years, they have been consistent on putting an anthem or something monumental in your hand for you to sing along to at all times. We conscious artists are too personal and sometimes elitist, and that is not a good attitude when doing entertainment. All right? I A&R conscious artist. I bring a lot of spoken word pockets into hip-hop because it is different. But it is lyricism that's the foundation, okay? So when they want to put a slab of information into 16-bar pockets, that is too much information
for people that have been dumbed out.
Mm.
You can't make records trying to save people in one phrase or one song. Mm. All right? You have to deal with them like a child. It's small spoonfuls. No matter how you want that child to grow fast, you can't give them more than they can handle or digest. We refuse to see that. And we continuously put out boom, 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 lyric, lyric, lyrics, information, content, 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 and lose every time. And then blame it on some hidden devil at the label that says, don't let that pass, don't let that pass. There is no such person. There is no such person. If you prove your market and you bring your bread to the table, anybody talking like this, like we should do a label, we should do an A&R, should have money in hand, period, because it's a business transaction. It's not a let's save the brothers and sisters thing. You're talking about business. That's where we lose. That's where we lose. Mm-hmm. Most of us are not educated in business the way we need to be. We're basically educated in business for bills and survival, not for business. Mm-hmm. All right? So, in other words, in order for the movement to do this, they have to be conditioned. All right?
Mm-hmm.
They have to be conditioned all the way out. Similar to what Brother Farrakhan was saying at the Million Man March, dividing into different houses, health, you know, this, that, you know, finance, whatever the case may be. That's the beginning of a conditioning. Even if you're not doing it with the Nation of Islam, do that in your movement. So that way, the finance people for the Nawabians can deal with the finance people of the Christians, and the finance people for the yoga can deal with the finance people for whoever else. And it's consistent spiritual and cultural business. I don't have to give a care about your color or anything. Now when you put out projects, you're putting it out in a network. Okay? So if you've already connected 8 houses that consistently say, as long as you provide quality, we will purchase. So that means them saying, we loyally use this brand of music because the house is built for music. Now, everybody can't be going to the music house, brother. You can't be the butcher and want to rap. You can't be the priest of the temple and want to rap. You got to let the messengers do what they do. And that's hard for people who have so much to say at this time and stage in 2014. We're information overload. I'm telling you the problems of why these label things don't work when people just get a bunch of people and do some recording and bounce off the walls of Def Jam and MCA and all of that stuff. Because it's not made to the format of what they're doing, period. So you either have to create a new format or condition yourself to understand what theirs is, and that doesn't mean selling yourself out.
Indeed.
You feel me?
Indeed.
It does not mean that. Certain areas of Tupac, people felt it was selling out because you're talking more booty than I have to understand. Feel me? But then you quell us down and give us a little jewels here and there, but you're never allowed to ride your straight lane because there's someone above you pulling strings and saying, we got to play entertainment. You can't be doing this black power thing up here with all these jewels and this platinum on and all these big butts out here. Come on, man. You got to bend a little bit. You can't come to Vegas trying to play like you in Mecca. All right? Real.
We got 3 minutes left, Brother Jay.
My Lord, I didn't mean to go further on the point, but I'm just trying to point to y'all where consciousness it doesn't blend, my Lord. I'm just trying to really state this to people. They think it's just like gather a bunch of people. I just went through about 13, 14 artists that feel like, yo, I'm positive teaching the kids, but you cursing out for the first 6 to 8 bars. I'm already turning your stuff off. I don't care how dope you are. How can I play that in front of someone talking about this is the new level of conscious music? You got to
practice.
Yeah, we got 90 seconds. 90 seconds. Thanks you for calling in, brother.
Peace.
No, Brother Jay, do you got anything going on right now that you want to shout out?
Magnegro album coming. Stay close to the Twitter, Bro J X Clan, Instagram, all of that. Stay close to that, and I'll inform you. And I'll be working with y'all team as well on letting y'all know about upcoming concerts and so on as well.
Definitely.
Okay.
And before we get off the air, Brother Jay, I want to thank you for coming on the show and let the callers know that
This right here, it was simple planning. I got at the brother got back at me, and I really respect that, especially in these days and times where people is, you know, above other people. But I really respect the brother for coming on the show, and I thank all y'all for calling in. And something simple as this, we can do it on a bigger level. Let's stop sharing these ratchet pics and videos on Facebook. Let's start getting the movement right. All it takes is one person. Each person do their part. We can have a black Facebook. We can have a black Facebook. Respect each other.
That's right. Gather that paper, man, and get your thing on. That's real.
All right.
Peace, family.
Thank you so much.
Peace. Thank you for having me. Bless.
Thank you. Peace.
Thank you.
All right, you guys. It was a great show. We about to be out of this. Peace. And go on and support the Tupac thing down there in L.A.
Well, I'm finna head there
right
now.
7825 Southwestern.
I'm heading there. I'm going to be the one with the Mark and Garvey Huey shirt on.
All right. I'll see you when you get here.
Peace.
Peace,
you going
too, Z? Nah, I probably won't be able to make it.
All right.
But peace to Brother Jay and everybody. All right, we out.
Peace, y'all.
Peace, family.
Very African. Come and step in Brother Temple, see what's happening. To take the bass flow, coming from a zero. Tell me what a sissy know. Funk a lesson is the new flow. Stalking, walking in my big black boots. Living off the earth, eating herbs and fruits. The children await me by the mountain and the river. And gather round the fire for the scroll that I deliver. The speak of a house is from the sand to the sky. And devils ever doubt and want to measure how high. Your logic reveals you, your mind can't catch it. The dimensions of a god go far beyond brackets. Coming to my oven, devils come and you burn. I can always feel vulture with the strength and black word. You're pissing me off because you swear you're higher level. Back to your cave, get yourself together. Chili and Magilla, chocolate and vanilla. How can polar bears swing on vines with the gorillas, please? Check your reason because there's something amiss. My home is a void, you're drowning in an abyss. I teach your funk code and don't preach a rap rhyme. Harambe to the sun as the mortals ask time.
Man, what time is it?
The funky lesson comes, the sundial speaks.
Man, what time is it?
The building of the strong are the lessons of the meek.
Man, what time is it?
My science is deep, my blackness is deep.
How deep?
Deep. Deeper than Atlantis, deeper than the seafloor, traveled by the mantis. Your copycats will never know. With you, the funk will never flow, but that's another blow. Make your move, thief apprentice, I never step. I'm a tribal move, your master hasn't figured yet. Bring your weapons to my sword and shield. What's the higher level if your shit ain't real? My mystic magic, what you gonna do? Think before you step before the rebel, silly mortal you. I tried to warn you, but your mind won't catch. You're just cookies in my oven. If I wanna burn a bat, you just burn.
Glorious. This is protected by the red, the black, and the green with a key, sissy.
Like this, like that, and like that, like this. How dark is the world, how strong is a fist. Originals come from the sand and the sword to the concrete, fighting wars in the street. The day of outrage, history, another page. We lack the word of this, but now there is a Brother Jay, the prince of warriors, leading masses. Stomping liver lip, punks playing asses. The damn sissies always stalk for the glory. Sissy bomb is coming, but that's another story. So many people forgot where they came. Disrespect religion, but the living is lame. Black, white, how you living? Blowing the now. Teach them many mortals, the chimes of a sundial. To the east, teaching gods to be what it was, what it is, and again shall be. What's my mind state if my state ain't black? But Moses, Malcolm, and Huey are back. And the voice to a many going verb to verb. Sit back and take heed, brother, you must learn. Swimming in the books, and the books ain't given. The scales of a black man weighs in the living.
What time is it?
I dwell among the mortals, the time is in the verse.
What time is it?
Positive nature, mortals call it curse.
What time is it?
Shadows in the sunlight, balance in the birth. Tick tock tick, we go sun to moon. Verbalizer speaks, it's a quarter to doom. Self-destruction is not a key function. Number bound the leaders, cause the people keep fronting. When will they realize the body needs head? It's more than what's said when a leader lies dead. Coming to the darkness, past is light. Death meaning life as the pharaohs take flight.
too much degrees for a silly pale thief. You can't define what's direct from the east. God protect me, he selects me. God makes the path so the world respects me. 0 to 9, grandest creator. I pray for those on both sides of equator. Professor X, when will they learn? Once life enters doors, death no return, no return.
This is an invitation to the crossroads. If you dare, Mississippi. With a key.